Everybody, it's Invicta. It's time for another Eden Run here, the Binding of Isaac Victa Repentance series. Happy Friday, Mosh Pit. I hope your days have gone off to a great start. Looking forward to the weekend. Looking forward to more football and all the video games, anime, all that kind of good stuff. Thank you all very much for the support thus far as January is starting to get down to a close here, the last Friday of the month. So I hope everyone's Fridays have gone off to a great start, like I said. Here's your meme of the day, artwork of the day, animation frame of the day. This is the first for me. Title Thread was posting a frame from an animation that I made that has Invicta posters in the background. This is posted by Looney Stuff. This one got lost in the sauce, so apologies, Looney Stuff, but I am very interested in seeing what animation comes from this, especially with the nice mapping loser reference there on the poster. Obviously, this was done way before yesterday's episode, but it's pretty pertinent now, and as always, so thank you very much, Looney Stuff. If you happen to post the animation, let us know in the comments, or let us know on the Invicta subreddit. Thank you very much for submitting that. Yeah, is going to be Korn and Northern Lion, Mike Foxtrot. I was going to say Mouth, but like that didn't make sense because there's no L there. So great tiers, good damage to start off with. We're also starting with the Compass, which I am absolutely 100% okay, and also starting with the Book of Shadows. So, I mean, hey, we want a monster start here. There you go. The only bad thing is basically our movement speed or lack thereof, and that's it. I'm going to wait on the Soul Heart, obviously. But obviously, starting with the Book of Shadows is fantastic, giving us early game invincibility so we can do fun stuff like, tank enemies or go through, early demon judgments where we normally would not have any full access to playing. I mean, all that stuff is on the board right now. So, and we're going to tempt fate here and push the button, even though you probably should never do so. Get Donation Machine, which, yeah, whatever. Gotta be careful, obviously. We only have one HP here. Now, if you were a smarter player than I or a more careful player than I, you'd go back and pick up that Soul Heart in the item room. We're not going to do that because, well, I have a little bit of faith in my skills or lack thereof, maybe. But more importantly, we do have the damage and tears rate to sort of keep us alive and keep us safe. So I'm not too worried about being on one heart. But I don't recommend doing that for newer players or for inexperienced players. Definitely take the Soul Heart just to save yourself from dying if you find yourself in this situation. But if you're experienced enough to keep yourself safe, then yeah, there's really no huge risk, I would say, to losing all of your HP here. I'm actually going to use the Book of Shadows now just to get rid of some of these turrets here, because the problem with this room is that the fat spiders will start pushing the turrets along and actually cause you to take damage from them pushing him while the turrets are still firing, by the way. So you don't want that to happen. And just keeping us, I mean, it does use up our opportunity to use it on the boss, but it's usually going to be a not too bad of a boss here on Cellar 1, so I'm not horribly worried about it. Again, I have much more confidence in our stats more than anything else, so I'm not too concerned about taking damage from Limehorn or really anyone. That's a good place to be at, but you know, that's not cockiness. That's not being overconfident. This is, slow and insidious killer, blah, blah, blah. That's just facts. There's nothing embellished here. That is just the facts. If your damage is good enough and your tears rate is good enough, you can keep yourself safe enough to where you just don't have to worry about really anything. Now, that doesn't mean that you're invincible. Obviously, don't be an idiot. But, more oftentimes than not, you're going to find yourself in a pretty easily solvable problem of having low life, but going up against a boss or waiting on a Soul Heart. Now, this is a self-inflicted wound here. Obviously, I didn't have to skip the Soul Heart, but we're going to do it anyway, and give ourselves a full heal thanks to Blue Cap. Also gives us a nice tiers upgrade. Does give us a shot speed down, which we don't really care about because our shot speed is quite good, despite us getting Blue Cap. And we could potentially get the secret room here. I know where the secret room is. We do get a bomb. Okay. Big room is going to be above the room that we have the donation machine in right now. We're going to go back and get the Soul Heart after we go in here. I mean, it wasn't a great trade, but hey, it's better than nothing. Obviously, we're not going to take Cursed Eye because Cursed Eye is still bad. Always be careful. Your first instinct in this room is to run right. The second one is to run right up the middle. Don't do either of those because you're guaranteed to take a hit. So, yeah. So, don't do that. I Trust me, I've been hit plenty in that room, but not this time. Not this day. Curse of the Maze. We do have a cheeky sacrifice room here, which I'm definitely down to play if we get enough HP for. Early game sacrifice rooms have been... Back-to-back Curse of the Maze procs. They have been proving to be quite useful. I'm just going to go ahead and do this now just because I don't feel like dealing with y'all. Y'all are hounding me. It's too early on a Friday morning here for me to really be hounded. I just want to enjoy my coffee that I don't drink and not take BBF. That's right. I didn't stutter. You heard correctly. I did not drink coffee. Coffee is one of those smells. That's 3 out of 4 procs for Curse of the Maze, by the way. That might be a record. Coffee is one of those clean smells. I classify as a clean smell. That's 4 out of 5 procs now for Curse of the Maze, by the way. I'm just pointing that out because, like, you never ever see that unless the game is truly already being trolly, which after yesterday's run, I mean, who freaking knows at this point, man? I don't know. It's been a whole day since I've recorded, so if I recall correctly, I was not too happy with yesterday's run. Mom's Toenail and Book of Shadows might not be that terrible, actually, but I'm just going to go ahead and not put myself through the stress anyway. Anyway, coffee is one of those clean smells that I've talked about in the past. It's a smell that, like, if I smell it, I feel like my environment is just cleaner. Now, as dumb as that may sound, it is true. For some reason, like, my smell, when I smell certain things, it alters the perception of, like, my environment a little bit. So, like, I can, like, if I'm in a restaurant and I smell, like, you know, like, just, like, dirty dishes or trash or something like that, if I'm in the same restaurant, I'm going to be, like, upset, obviously. But if I'm in the same restaurant under the same environment and stuff and I smell, like, vinegar, or if I smell coffee, or if I smell, like, you know, light cleaning products. I'm not talking about straight bleach. I'm just talking about, you know, cleaning product stuff. It's going to make me think that the place is much cleaner, even though it's the same exact, you know, like, stinky restaurant that I was previously in. I don't know what kind of relational memory that is. Maybe there's a scientist out there in the mosh pit that can explain that, but, like, there's other clean smells out there. Like, vinegar is a strong one for me. If I smell vinegar, I automatically feel like I'm just in a cleaner environment. Olive oil is another one that smells. It's a very clean smell, you know. I'm not sure if that actually, like, is a category of actual smells that exist in the world, but, or maybe they all share the same thing. Like, you know, like, I mean, vinegar is used for a variety of cleaning stuff. Like, I use vinegar to clean a lot of things around the house. The best thing, honestly, that I used it for is my shower door. Like, my standing shower door, like, it gets, like, soap scum and, like, all kinds of, like, you know, like, it just gets just soap scum and it gets cloudy and hazy and stuff. Dude, use vinegar and, like, hot water on that and just wait for, like, 10 minutes and then get one of those, like, magic erasers from Mr. Clean and you're set. Like, I promise you, like, try it. Like, try it. If you need a go-to solid recommendation for like, you know, cheap and environmentally friendly cleaning products, hey, white vinegar, man. It's the bomb dizzle. And I wasn't sure at first, but, like, I used it on the shower door and it got it all, like, sparkly clean and stuff, I was like, man, I got to use this for other things. There's darkness. Look, a shadow is coming up in clutch. We got another sacrifice room, which, honestly, I wish that we had the HP to play, but apparently we do not. I get Bloody Gust from the Devil Deal, which is going to give us a Tears Up and a Movement Speed Up every time we take damage. It doesn't matter what the source is. So we're not really trying to take damage, but if we do take damage, hey, at least we get something back for it. That's value right there. Looking for the Petrified Poop. If it can drop out of here, that'd be great. Petrified Poop is another great source of early game economic adventures. Sources of value, etc., etc. all of our dips just get completely murked in here. Tigrum might be here. I'm not totally sure on that. Yeah. Yeah, that's usually, I would say, a 60-40 chance for the secret room, but in this case here, I didn't get a chance to look at that other room that was to the upper left of it, so gamble that didn't pay off. I doubt we'll get a reroll machine. Probably just gonna spawn a bunch of crap in here. No. Okay. Another one of those rooms that's very good in understanding how much damage it's going to require to kill an enemy, so you don't accidentally walk yourself into a death rattle of the Dark Chargers. Yeah, that's what I thought. The reverse Hangman card basically turns us into the Tainted Keeper, essentially. Show you. There you go. One of those items that, like, I really don't use that often, because I either forget what it does, or it's not something that I even think about. But if you need money, though, the reverse Hangman card can be quite good. We're seeing right here, giving us the inner eye effect along with the Tainted Keeper effect, where just everything just drops money, and we don't have to worry about having the Keeper's HP as our, well, as our HP. Like, we don't have to worry about having coins. There we go. So now that we've made enough money to get something from the store, I think the secret might be there, but hard to tell without having a bomb. Yeah, it's there. Chaos is a possibility, but I'm going to wait to see if we get a devil deal first. The chaos has not been seen for quite a while. It's not really an item that I really bank for, and I've already regretted not taking it because we get ourselves a horseman here. You really just want to try to take Pestilence down to phase two here, and then it becomes much easier. You didn't quite slide around all over the place. Of course, that being said, it also apparently he just puts himself in the only corner in the room that we can't hit from the side. There you go. Thank you. All right, ball of bandages, and we get Judas's freaking shadow. I tell you what. Okay, so this is quite the good thing for us because we can turn into Black Judas. And in fact, I will turn into Black Judas now. Get Ansa's. We don't want to die in the curse room. I will take Chaos. Chaos is going to shuffle up all of the loot tables, and in fact I think I'll wait until the next floor before we turn ourselves into Black Judas. I want to use this Ansa's rune here. We could go into the sacrifice room, but there's no real point because we can only tap it once and then that's that. Okay, there's Ansa's. Now we can go into the boss trap room here in a second. We could take whatever's in there. Now, if there's an HP upgrade, then we might want to wait before we turn into Black Judas. There's not an HP upgrade. Ventral Spirit. I mean, it's kind of whatever. There's a Sanitarium over there. There we go. So big time damage upgrade here. As soon as we take the role of Black Judas, we get the damage multiplier as well as Tears upgrade. Now, that being said, of course, we did take Chaos, and the Planetarium is not guaranteed to give us a Planetarium item. In fact, it's probably more guaranteed that we aren't going to get a Planetarium item. Get a wild card, which is very interesting. Use this to double our Book of Shadows effect, or basically copy whatever thing that we did, we can copy it with. Like, take a rune, for example, or use the D6, or use the Book of Shadows, or it will do whatever the last thing you did was. If I poop here, could come in clutch for a Soul Harder 2. Now, we do have to be a little bit more cautious with our HP here because, obviously, Black Judas can only take Soul Hearts as HP. But with the Book of Shadows, we can just run right over things and even save our Wisps that we get from Central Spirit. So in an emergency, if we need to use two Book of Shadow charges, we can with a wild card. Hopefully we don't ever get into that mess, but just in case we do. And yeah, Squeezy, Shade here. I'm less enthused about Lost Contact, but I will take it anyway. Other reason why I say I'm less enthused about that is basically because we don't have the tiers rate. I mean, our tiers rate is good. Don't get me wrong. 4.52 is great. But I'd still rather have something like Piercing Shots or something like that where we can really outgun our opponents without having to really worry about getting, running into a situation where the enemy is shooting out more tiers than we can produce and block. Therefore, it turns an enemy with high tiers rate into them having a very high amount of defense because we have to not only go through all their tiers that they're shooting at us at a faster rate than we do, but we also have to, of course, inflict damage on them. So it's a little bit counterintuitive, and that's why you'll see me, generally speaking, you'll see me skip over Lost Contact quite a bit. Keep that penny. Definitely would enjoy a bit of flying here. Don't really want Ghost Baby. Queen of Hearts. If this is a library or something like that, or even like a cursed room, we could get some hearts out of here. We did, but unfortunately it wasn't the type of hearts that I wanted. Yeah, that's really the only downside when it comes to Black Judas is the fact that he cannot get any red heart containers. You would have to transform into someone else. Even if you get Eternal Hearts, it's only going to give you, or a Strength card, for example, it's only going to give you more Soul Hearts to work with. So you just have to keep that in mind. Of course, you're playing like a super juiced up version of Blue Baby, so kind of hoping that we can get like some kind of Soul Hearts here, Judgment, but I guess we're just going to keep getting red hearts. Car battery's fine for Book of Shadows. I will use the strength card for a devil deal if we end up getting one. I'm just going to use the Book of Shadows here and just plow over everything. And we do not get devil deal here. But we do get some Victor Robes, which I'm fine with. I am going to hold on to the wild card over the strength card. It just makes more sense that way. And we've got ourselves a powerhouse coming up with this combo. The ability for us to use the Book of Shadows in conjunction with the Wisps that we get from Ventral Spirit and also the damage we get from Shade and also the damage we get from our Swarm Protector as well as Ball of Bandages. It's pretty potent. You got to keep in mind, again, with the... I guess we're just doing this room again. With the car battery, we're also getting a double charge out of our Book of Shadows. So that's just value on value on value. Like this room, I can't be bothered to try to outgun two Monstros when we can just run over them. Much easier to do so. Quicker and more efficient. Do get maxed out tiers right here almost, thanks to us having the Torn Photo. Now, if you're wondering how come our tiers rate went down from the last floor, that is because we had a couple of instances where we got hit for damage, and that gave us some extra little boostage in the form of Bloody Gust. The first Devil Deal item that we took, which gives us tiers and movement speed whenever we take damage. And now, yeah, we are almost—we're only 0.03 of a point away from being fully maxed out. Well, at the soft cap anyway of our tiers rate, which is good. Really, we can use the Book of Shadows every other... every two rooms, not every other room. If we had the 9-volt in every other room, we'd be just super powerful. I mean, we're already pretty dang powerful. I'll take it. Boss Rush is still an outside possibility, but I'd be surprised. Money here for us. Again, this is one of those rooms, even when I'm super powerful, I don't ever feel like really fighting. Especially if it's double champion Chubb. And notice the duration of Book of Shadows is still going here. It might have been a soul heart that fell. I gotta go back and look. Prioritizing boss rush is kind of important. Yeah, it was. It's kind of important when you've got chaos because you really don't know what other items you can find. And obviously it can be from any loot table in there. So you really, really, really want to, if you can, help it, try to go for boss rush if possible. But if you're in a situation where, like we are, where like I don't think we're going to make it, then it's probably, you know, if you have an outside shot, go for it. But if not, then don't worry about it. Also don't remember if we went to the item room or not. Where did we get the torn photo from? Was that from an item room? Super secret room's gonna be right there. Let's save the bombs because we don't have a whole lot of them. Push these chests over. Okay. Blow up this keeper over here too. Might as well. So boss rush is off the table, which is kind of what we expected anyway. I, for the life of me, do not remember if we went... I know we didn't go to the store on this floor. I don't remember if we found the item room or not. I don't think we did either. Sacrifice room, that's not enough for us. Okay, yeah, so that's where we got torn photo from, okay. But we need to still find the store. So we don't have enough HP for us to really play the sacrifice room. Should be the way to the store. Should be. Now, the stores, normally I wouldn't put so much emphasis on the store, but if you have chaos for the stores, unless, of course, it's a greed fight, for the stores to have reroll machines is very, very powerful for you. It's the best chance you can get to have, like, really, really good items. And the whole reason why you go for chaos is because of the potential for you to get any item in the game from store rerolls. And it's pretty common to find reroll machines or restock machines inside of stores, obviously. So, again, you're more incentivized to prioritize getting into the store more than anything else. Unless, of course, you get a greed fight, then it doesn't matter because that's just how the mop flops sometimes. That's Isaac, baby. Et cetera, et cetera. Be Fallen. Here's where we can definitely outgun Fallen. One thing we can't do anything about is going to be the Brimstone Beam. Again, you're seeing here, we have nothing to worry about, and that's going to be a 73% deal with the Devil failure, although it doesn't really matter because we don't get Devil deal items anyway because of Chaos. Okay. Being said, let's hope that we do get an actual store here. Some more damage would also be quite welcome. Maybe we already have more damage than we did on yesterday's run, obviously, but that's because of us being Black Judas. Yeah, we'd like to get some Rotten Hearts, but unfortunately, we've gone the wrong way. Because according to Isaac map logic, in order for us to go west, we have to go southeast. All right. We double back here. There's almost no reason for us to go into the curse room. Again, with chaos, it's give and get, right? You know, you get the opportunity to get some of the best items in the game from unlikely sources, but your regular sources of normal acquisition places, acquisition rooms, I'm not sure how to say that, the places that you normally get good stuff, they're obviously kind of diminished because of chaos, and that's the downside of it. Which is sometimes the reason why you'll see me not take chaos is for that very reason. I don't like having my loot tables disrupted whenever I'm on a roll or if I've got like a really good strong build going. But if a build is particularly weak or like, you know, if the boss items just haven't been there or whatnot, then I'm not gonna put too much blame onto chaos. I'd rather take my chances in the stores and whatnot. It's super greed in here, which means there cannot be a greed fight in here, but unfortunately we do get another dud of a store and no reroll machines. So. Some money back in the old donation machine. Cool card in case we needed it. And we should try to go get a Book of Shadows charge real quick. Do we really need it against Mom? No, probably not, but it will make the fight a lot easier. And it's, generally speaking, probably worth doing. At a very little risk to us. Unless, of course, I pop a brimstone bomb right next to me. Thankfully, we shot it away fast enough. Alright, so chaos so far. I mean, Synthoil was great for us, but not really the greatest of acquisitions, I would say. And again, that disruption of your items is kind of where chaos falls flat for me a lot of the times. Especially when like we have a reliable source of damage upgrades here with devil deals and that sort of thing. I don't necessarily want chaos to be doing that. We do get a Guppy item, which is actually surprising. We'll take Guppy's paw. We'll see if we can complete the Guppy circle. This room, I always try to say, get rid of the wall spiders first. You can help it, because that will greatly increase the amount of mobility you can get in this room. Saw how close that we got up against it there with these eggies running at us. Any boss might be Ed. Plain old Envy. Avi she was flying up on the right hand side, like there was a purpose there for a second. I was wondering if there was a crawl space over there. Excuse me. Like, going back to the smells thing though, like there's certain smells that just get me. You know, like there's smells that just they take you back. Very clean smells. And then there's also smells that, like, I just cannot stand. Like cigarette smoke, smokers in the world, I'm sorry. I mean nothing by this, but I'm allergic to cigarette smoke. It sucks. I used to work around cigarette smoke all the time as a bartender, and I hated every second of it. I was constantly sick. Like, I didn't know what it was like to breathe in without smelling cigarette smoke at one point in my life. And I'm so happy not being around it, but it just makes it even more obvious, like now, that I'm not surrounded by cigarette smoke anymore. And whenever I do smell it, it's like, ugh, man. Cigarette smoke is one of the worst for me. the smell that just ruins my day. I'd say like dirty diapers are pretty bad. If you go to someone's house and like they don't necessarily throw away their trash after changing their kid or whatever, it's pretty bad. That's no bueno. Oh, wow, we get Deadeye here. It's been a while since we've seen Deadeye. Deadeye is going to give us a stacking damage shot that will increase in damage and size. The longer that we are able to nail a target, it's also going to glow red. See, like that. Yeah, and Deadeye ramps up super quick with Black Judas. Deadeye is fantastic to go along with Lusty Blood if you can get it. To bomb the Rotten Beggar just to give us a little bit of an extra chance of maybe getting a Devil Deal. Again, not that it matters because of Chaos, but Celery is another one that I cannot do. I've talked about my hatred of celery in the past. It stems from I don't like vegetables, and B, I really, really strongly hate the scent of celery because it reminds me of this weed that grew in Bermuda called sting nettle, which is not just native to just Bermuda. It's very tropical. It's a tropical weed, and yeah, there's the failed 85% deal with the devil. All right. All right. Yeah, the smell of celery just... ugh. I can't describe it. It's revolting. It's not as bad as cigarette smoke, but it's almost there. Like, it's that bad. Now, strangely, one thing I will say is, strangely enough, the only time... like, I can't eat celery for the life of me. I can't. I've tried and I can't do it. It makes me feel like I'm eating, like, long clippings. But the only time that I can stomach celery that I don't mind the smell of it is when it's in, like, Thanksgiving stuffing form. That's the only time where I'm like, you know what, celery, it's not that bad. It's pretty horrid. Don't get me wrong. It's pretty horrid, but I can stomach it if it's in, like, a Thanksgiving way. Other than that, you can keep your celeries, bro. I'm done. Stick a fork in me, I'm done. It's not great. Now, with Wild Card, we could replicate Card Against Humanity if we need more HP, which honestly, like, we haven't seen a Soul Heart, I feel like, in quite a while. We haven't been taking that much damage either, thanks to Book of Shadows, but, like, also, we haven't really been given an opportunity to get too many Soul Hearts here, so, yeah, we're not going to get one here either. All right. All right. I think we do it. It's a pretty big room that has lots of clearance. It would take forever and a day to clear, but the prospect of us getting a full rack of hearts is too great for me to pass up. So we're going to use our wild card here, and we're going to forgo our opportunity to use two books of shadows in hopes that we get enough HP here to where that won't even matter. Let's count how many eternal and soul hearts we get. All right. Starting off with zero. Here we go. Petrified Poop. All right. Here's one. One and a half. Well, technically, I guess only one soul heart. One collective soul heart. All right. There's two. Two and a half. All right. 2.5. Two and a half soul hearts. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Well, if we ever get a judgment, we know that at least we'll have plenty to spend, question mark. But was that worth giving up a doubled Book of Shadows? I'm going to say no, it wasn't. It was not at all. Okay. Get one of the soul hearts back here from the eternal heart. Again, you see how fast Deadeye just ramps up. Pours on the pressure, but gonna be a not photo finish here. See if Chaos can help us out. Curse the Unknown. Telekinesis, Ventricle Razor, Tough Love, and Bob's Brain. Alrighty. Duality, gonna be not really all that effective right now at the course of this run. We'll say that. But really what this run comes down to is just the Book of Shadows, because man, Book of Shadows plus Vengeful Spirit of all things is not, it's not bad. I mean, I'll take it, but honestly, like the double Book of Shadows with car battery is just, it is too good. You get an Orbital, even if you don't have an Orbital, like you're still going to deal enough damage to take down most bosses before the duration even gets halfway done. So we'll definitely take it. We'll take it. A nice easy Friday afternoon here, or maybe early Friday morning run of Isaac. Thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you had a great start to your week. And thank you for liking, commenting, subscribing. I really appreciate it. Definitely go check out all the artwork on the Invictus subreddit. And, of course, if you've not already, check out my Patreon campaign. The new month is coming up soon. You have a couple of days left to get added to the Patreon and get added to the list before the processing starts on, I believe, the 1st of February. So thank you, those of you who are signed up on the Patreon. Thank you for those of you who join our Discord as well as those of you who post on the Invictus subreddit. As always, I'll see you all next time. Until then. So long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like T. Ryan, Anthony Bennett, Alexei Sokolov, Austin Parente, and Carlos Ibanez. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find over at patreon.com/Invicta.